No, I really think there's just one thing.
My diet tip for adhering to your plan and making progress is,
for anybody that's trying to get into health and fitness and just live a healthier lifestyle, my recommendation to you is,
I think for me, I'm gonna have to say
the two biggest things that come to my mind.
I think you should always,
no one gave that advice because,
is that
one,
enough?
Right? One good.
Hello everybody!
Yeah. She's kindly put Rob and I up for the next couple of days while we're still here in LA.
I literally think I lure people into my house by making them an espresso for my Nespresso machine.
Oh,
everyone's like, oh my gosh, this coffee, it looks so good. So we're just having some breakfast and we're gonna get the day started. So day starting with some work. I actually have a lot of work to catch up on and Sarah has to edit a video, so we'll catch you guys soon.
Can you stop making noise when I'm trying to...
Sorry, I'm ruining everything. I'm just gonna go back to Harlem.
I'm just gonna go back. How was your photo shoot this morning?
It was awesome. It was like nice and early. It was by the beach, so it really kind of woke us up. And yeah, we're all feeling good, planning out our day. It's gonna
cool
be a good
stuff.
One.
We're gonna have a fun day today, so we're gonna get the day started. But before that, I wanna talk a little bit about something that I thought of at the LA Fit Expo when a ton of people were coming up to me. And during meeting everybody in line, some people stopped to ask questions. And like the number one question was just like, what are your tips on dieting? What do I do? Like, I'm trying to eat healthy, but like, I just forget that after like being, after like tracking my macros for such a long time, after being like in the fitness industry for such a long time, I kind of forget like people, the way that you might think if you're just getting started and you really just don't know. So what I'm gonna do today, now that I have a ton of YouTubers here, that's literally like in my complex right now. We have Rob, we have Sarah, Emily Duncan's here, Marie's here, she just moved in. Obviously Emily Hayden, Randy Kennedy's here, Karen, and a bunch of just people are everywhere. So I'm gonna get everybody's advice, what their tips on dieting are. So number one, Rob Lipset.
Okay, whoa, whoa.
On the spot.
Put me on the spot here. But yeah, I've actually been asked this a couple of times, and I really think there's just one thing, and it's just adherence. It's just sustainability. Like, and whatever approach that may be, like, you know, you see a few people on, especially on YouTube and stuff, and they're like, you have to, intermittent fasting is the best way, or like, clean eating is the best way, or it fits your macros is the only way, and there's no only way. It's literally just whatever you like to do. Like, it can be a combination of everything. So it's just finding whatever you can adhere to, because you can follow the quote-unquote best diet, but if you can't stick to it, it's useless. So adherence is kind of my number one. So good. Nah, that turned out nicely.
I meant to do that.
So something that helps me adhere to my diet is eating stuff that actually tastes good. So this is just a packet of oatmeal, and then I put some select protein in here. This helps me hit my protein goals for the day. It's not totally necessary for you to hit your protein goals. You can obviously have things like meat, chicken, you can have egg whites, you can have other things that have protein in them, but I just really like the taste of this, and it helps like kind of curb my sweet tooth. So I will mix this in here. Also gonna do a half serving of mini chocolate chips. Again, it helps me adhere to my diet because as long as I fit this in my macronutrients for the day, I can have it. It's not bad. Nothing is bad. There's no good or bad foods. Remember that. Also having a tablespoon of the Bee's Knees peanut butter, and I'm gonna put a few blueberries in here to top it off. Does this not just look like heavenly? So I'm gonna put the macros up on the side of the screen for you guys so you know what this equates to and how I'm fitting into my day.
Where am I?
We have another friend. Marie just moved in. Well, not in with me, but she moved into the complex.
Yeah, we're neighbors now.
She's my neighbor now. Okay, Marie.
Okay, so my diet tip for adhering to your plan and making progress is finding foods that you like to eat and making your food taste good, whether that be with seasoning, picking different varieties of foods, or just finding like new exciting things that you like. Try something new each week. Always keep it fresh, keep it different, interesting, so you don't get bored. You don't have to eat stuff that you don't like. Another really important thing to remember is that when you are pouring a serving or putting a serving on your plate, it is often a lot different than what's on the nutrition label. So it can be helpful to have something like a food scale or measuring cups handy. You don't have to always use them, but every once in a while, it's a good idea to check your like eyeball estimation skills and make sure that you're getting a good serving in, because the difference between one serving of peanut butter and four servings of peanut butter is huge, but doesn't necessarily look that different.
Yeah. All right, Emily, don't, oh my God, but my background in the house. Sorry, everybody. I have friends staying with me.
No,
it's not like.
I'm not okay. A total garbage person.
All right, am I good?
Yes.
All right, so for anybody that's trying to get into health and fitness and just live a healthier lifestyle, my recommendation to you as far as diet goes would be find your staple foods, your staple meals, foods that you enjoy, that are palatable to you, that also help you meet your macros, your micros, all of that, but that you also just know how to cook really, really fast. You know, have your backbone, have your skeleton of your meals, your food selections, all of that, things that you digest really easily. You don't want to like mess up your digestive system or anything like that, and have those staple meals, those staple foods in there, and then allow yourself, you know, your favorite treats to fit in those spaces in between in the backbone.
That's perfect. Okay, me two staple meals that you like.
Okay, one of my staple meals is oatmeal with egg whites and a little bit of select protein. That's like a really great pre or post workout.
I literally just put that in the
yes,
video.
Yes, it's a favorite. And it just tastes super good. It's warm. I live in the cold. I live in Louisville, so it's like nice and warm and just like fills up your
Wait,
stomach.
Wait, how did you say Louisville?
Louisville. Yeah, people that aren't from there say Louisville. I know, it's like, yeah, so eggs and egg whites, oatmeal, and some select protein in there, especially the snickerdoodle one, because that's so good. And then okay, this is super weird. People say that I'm so weird for this, but I found, like, I had this meal because my coach put it in my peak week. But it's chicken, sweet potatoes, peanut butter, and then if you're like really adventurous, some banana on there. It's like this weird sweet and savory combo. It's like got protein, carbs, fat, so it's just like a really good mixed meal.
Perfect. Thanks, Em.
You're welcome.
Advice from Emily Duncan. Sometimes I pretend one serving is two serving, or two
one
servings
serving is one jar.
Yeah.
One
yeah.
Serving.
Single serve jar.
Just kidding. I usually weigh it on this and then make sure it's one. Yeah. So fun.
Yeah. It
we just
takes
finished.
The pressure that. Off. Like being on camera, you can like flow yeah. more with talking.
And you don't have to like keep people enticed for like. You can't talk for longer than 3 minutes on YouTube because people will click out of the video and then the watch time goes down.
Don't blah, 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 blah.
We just finished up.
Bougie Radio!
There's an A on this mug, but it should say M, because Meg. Meg's glance.
It's for awesome.
Okay,
it's
that
for
works too.
Acehole.
And there's Yami back here. She was with Meg, and she came to the podcast.
Our podcast
literally
audience.
Just listened
you guys
in.
You need to listen to it. It's really good.
Well, it'll be out. Everybody keeps asking me when the podcast is going to be out. Guys, I'm telling you, I'm waiting for my website to be done, and then I'll be putting podcasts out once a week, once it's up. So, like, you guys
it.
Will be getting them out once a week. But Meg just finished up with me, and it was great. Actually,
it's
it was a really
gonna
good
be,
podcast.
You think so?
It went so well. I
oh,
think.
It's going to be good.
You guys should watch it or listen to it.
Watch
I need
it.
To stop saying watch. Listen.
Yeah.
It's a podcast. You listen to it. So.
You're living in an audio-only space.
Yeah. Also, you two are here now. We have two YouTubers here.
We're here.
Fitness YouTubers, right? That's
oh,
what you do?
Yeah. Is it?
Is it? This video of today is... about nutritional tips. I told
oh,
you guys before.
Yeah, you told right. us about this.
So why don't we, you go and then you go.
You ready for my nutrition tips?
Yes. Nutrition tip from
a powerlifter.
A powerlifter named Meg Squats. What's one thing that you tell somebody who goes and asks you like, hey, what are your best tips for nutrition? What do you say? Like something super new for beginners.
New. Keep it simple. And just make one good decision at a time.
That's good.
Is that
one,
enough? For
one
you?
Good, yeah. That's good. One good decision at a time.
I talked a lot on the podcast.
That's so true. Y'all can listen to that. Yami, what's yours?
I think for me, I'm going to have to say consistency. Because I know for me, when I was a beginner, I was like, why the fuck is nothing happening?
And how long was nothing happening for? 2 weeks and then you stopped?
No, for quite a while.
No, you're just kidding.
Quite a while.
See, even though it takes quite a while... You still have to stay consistent
yes,
regardless.
Yes, 100%. Because, you know, we get upset or defeated or we think we're doing something wrong. But if you just keep going, keep grinding it out, it'll happen. So stay consistent and
good.
Keep it simple.
Good. Stay consistent, keep it simple. Like squats, yummy mufti. All right, guys. So today our bite meals are supposed to get delivered to our house, but there was a little mistake where they got delivered to Rhode Island. So
sad little YouTuber has to go to the grocery store. I know, it's sad. Like, I'm just like imagining all the comments, like, well, you have to go grocery shopping.
Yeah.
No, but I'm all serious since I don't have any food in my house, so where's my car at? I also have to find my car. I think it's that one parked over there that's not parked close to the curb at all. I think that's me.
Where's my car?
Yeah, anyways, so we're headed to the grocery store, so this is a good opportunity for me to show you guys a grocery haul with Rob Lipset.
Yeah, very exciting.
He likes American grocery stores.
Yeah, there's some stuff that we can't get, so yeah, I'm so bored.
Like Halo Top and stuff like that, yeah. But no, we're gonna get some, I don't even know what else I need. I'll actually probably get more stuff for you guys.
Yeah, we'll see.
I need some basic stuff, so we're gonna head to the grocery store. I'll catch you guys there. I just pulled out the grocery cart, and Rob goes...
I was like, yo, you don't have to put a coin in that. That is so strange.
Y'all
like,
need coins in Ireland?
In Ireland, everyone steals them and like goes in hills. Or
people
like,
steal them here too? That's a smart idea.
Yeah, there's like a little coin slot there and everyone, you put the coin in to take it. But some people are like, man, I'll spend, you know, a euro to steal a trolley.
That's hysterical. Let's do some health stuff first. Rob is like immediately going in this direction. No, this is health. Okay.
Okay, we're going full on here.
Where are the samples? This is the best part of the grocery store, and it's empty.
Everyone knows that samples contain no macros or calories, right?
Ever.
Yeah. It's science.
Especially at like Whole Foods when they have good samples of everything. And I want to do some of this health.
Yeah, I want to get some health.
What kind do you like?
Well, I actually like these. These are all right, but these look like a mixture of both.
Oh, can we do a fun slow-mo of grocery food stuff?
Yeah.
Vegetables at the grocery store, or else people on YouTube are gonna yell at me.
Yeah, they get pretty pissed off. You don't eat your vegetables.
If I get shredded lettuce, everyone's like, get kale.
Yeah,
so
it's never good enough.
Let's get some of this. Yeah. Actually, I think I even have some of this. Whatever, we'll get it anyway for YouTube.
Yeah.
I'll eat it. I swear.
I'll eat it too. Yeah. Maybe.
Water? Do you want a gallon of water?
Yeah, I'll go for some water.
Coke Zero, perhaps?
Oh yeah, that's actually how I like to drink my water. It's like full of aspartame.
Aspartame?
Aspartame, or however you say it.
Aspartame.
Oh my god.
Like, turn the label.
That is just, like I've never seen this. This is rare.
I'm rare, like Mr. Clean with hair.
Like I just saw a ghost.
Diet 7-Up cherry.
Cherry, oh, this is wild.
That is like a wild Rich Piana appears.
Yeah,
if you haven't seen Rob's video with Rich Piana in it, you should check it out.
It's cool, yeah. We have romance.
Coke Zero. Oh, that stuff's good too. I feel like that's better for summer though. Yeah, get those little mini guys.
These.
Or even since we have a lot of us here, let's get the 20 can thing. Because we all like Coke Zero.
Yeah.
Put that there. Good stuff. Unsweetened vanilla. I'm actually gonna get two of these because
it doesn't go off.
No, it's fine. Two of those. Aaron likes which one? This is the one I like. I forget which one she likes. Whatever. I think she just got herself some. I like this liquid stuff.
Yeah, it's easy to put in your whatever.
It's convenient.
Oh yeah.
Halo.
Okay, yeah, here we go.
Cookie dough. Oatmeal cookies, my favorite!
Yeah,
I haven't had this forever.
Yeah, I already tried a new one.
This is the best one.
You cannot get this in Ireland, so like I lose my shit when I see these.
And cookie dough. I'll take a cookie dough.
Yeah.
Why don't you get like 10 for Sarah? Because she'll eat them all tomorrow.
Yeah, she really will. I really want to try this one. S'mores.
It's good.
Is it good or is it great? Like,
it's good. Oatmeal cookies, my favorite. Marie really likes s'mores. I actually, weirdly enough, like almond crunch. Two of these. Which one's the cheaper? This one's the cheaper one. Kroger brand. I
Joe
can't do.
Loves Kroger. Travis S.
Travis S. loves Kroger.
This. What up, Trav? Also, Ireland sucks for crazy yogurts as well. This stuff.
The stuff is pretty wild.
Triple zero?
Yeah. It's like
I've never even seen that.
Yeah, look. You get it. If you eat this, you play in the NFL.
That's
a fact.
I would think another good tip would be to not copy what your favorite YouTubers or sports stars are doing for their diet and focus on something that's good for you.
I'm not serious.
Not serious. This was a mini grocery haul. I have plenty of stuff at home. I have some chicken at home. I have a little bit of fruit at home. I have peanut butter at home. I have some of the main things at home. So this is like a mini grocery haul, but I hope you guys enjoyed it because we did. Good, how are you? And then you can use some of the bags. There's two, and then his stuff can also go in these bags. So.
That's right.
That bag can hold house like the bigger things, maybe.
Okay.
Karen, you look so pretty.
Yeah.
If someone is asking you a tip about nutrition, and they want to know what they're gonna do to start off, they have no idea about anything about macros, anything about calories, anything about protein, carbs, and fat, what would you tell them?
The two biggest things that come to my mind is, number one, less isn't always best.
That's good.
So I get a lot of clients that come to me that are in huge deficits already just because they think restriction is the answer to weight loss, and that's definitely not always best. So less is not always best. And also, don't just do something just because you see somebody else doing it. That's another thing. I get a lot of people that will go on my social pages or my YouTubes or my YouTube or my Instagram and might say things like, oh, we're the same size. We look like we're about the same weight. What are your macros? Just because those are my macros doesn't mean that they'll be good for you just because we're about the same size, or just because somebody is doing something doesn't mean it's going to be the best thing for you. So don't always do things just because somebody else is doing them. Do your research and do what's best for you.
Where can they do good research?
Bodybuilding.com is a fantastic resource. When I first got started in fitness, I prepped for my first show by myself simply with resources from bodybuilding.com. I prepped for the first 10 weeks for my first show.
Articles like every single day, videos.
There's training programs.
YouTube channel, podcasts.
Create a body space, and there's like tons of support on there. There's tons of training programs and like nutrition guidelines that you can follow based on, you put in like your specifics. And yeah, it's like pretty generic, but for somebody that's just getting started, it's like such an amazing resource. And honestly, like I said, I prepped for my first show for the first 10 weeks just with resources from bodybuilding.com, and I ended up winning that show. So,
hell yeah.
Bodybuilding.com.
Advice from Karen Pellini.
On Amanda's jacket.
Love it. Rob?
Yeah, I was like, when are you going to ask me?
Wait,
like,
and the shoes, and the shoes.
Oh, these are misguided.
Love.
I have got Forever 21 jeans on, Alpha Lead lifestyle top, Aldo shoes that you picked out, movement watch, and that is everything.
I forget where I got this shirt from. I just got it. Do you remember?
I was with you.
I forget where I got it. Oh, I got it at Irene's story.
Oh, right. In the not the promenade.
Yeah, I think Marina. I forget who I was with. Anyway, these pants are flare, like they're suede, and they're from Fashion Nova. And shoes are from Steve Madden. They're like chunky, cute.
Very nice.
So cute.
I don't have a watch on because like sweaters.
All right, guys, so I'm driving. Rob is filming for me. But we're gonna ask Sarah the same question. So Sarah, if there's one nutrition tip that you can give someone just starting out, why don't we talk about going out to eat since that's what we're doing right now? Go.
Okay, because we're going out to eat, I'm gonna talk about what I personally do when I'm going out to eat and everything. Firstly, I think you should always incorporate like social events and everything. That's so important to spend time with friends and family, and your diet shouldn't get in the way of that. So personally, what I like to do is I just save some of my carbs and fats so I can have a bit more leeway when I do go out. And I always just try to make sensible options. Obviously, sometimes I will just, you know, go and have whatever I want, but most of the time I will just make sensible options. And don't be afraid to order things that are off the menu. Most of the time people will be quite accommodating to you, and you can also ask for like dressings and stuff on the side, just, you know, they can be quite high in fat and stuff. So just be smart about your choices when you're out. That's what I would say.
Solid.
More hey. Irish people talking, please.
Hello, my name's Rob. I do fitness from time to time.
Here we are. I'm gonna park right here. We made it to dinner. We're going to Neptune's. It's like a raw sushi bar. I'm excited. I don't know what I'm gonna get, but I'll let you guys know.
Alright,
we got a couple of things for. I'm getting the goat cheese.
Guess I'll join in.
Salad. And I'm also gonna get poke with some rice.
Rob is also getting some poke with rice. And weirdly enough, there's all these good things on the menu, but I'm just kind of craving some plain poke or tuna rice. I could get a burger. I could get. I'm gonna get a bunch of cool stuff, but like, I kind of just wanna.
See, I told you, it's all we need together somewhere.
Why are you not getting that?
That was
actually very nice. Yeah, yeah. Oh, thank you. We
shall see. He's undecided.
Hi, Kelvin.
Hello.
Oh, that's so cute. Video. You clearly got a ton of different advice from a lot of different YouTubers and people who have spent a lot of their time figuring out the best way that nutrition works for them. As you saw, no one necessarily gave a concrete, like, this is how you diet. Do these macros, do these cardio, do this type of training. No one gave that advice because it's different for everybody. So my best advice for you is that just get started. Don't be afraid that something has to be completely perfect, completely optimal, the number one best way to do things. A lot of people are just terrified because they don't know what to do, but nobody knows what to do when they first get started. None of us really knew what to do. We kind of just started something, saw if it worked for us. If it didn't necessarily work, we changed things up a little bit. And at the end of the day, everyone's gonna have something different that works best for them. So just try something, just get started, use all the resources you possibly can, do your research, figure out the best thing that works for you, and don't be afraid to just do something and try it, even though it's not gonna be perfect the first time you do it. So. Again, resources you can use, bodybuilding.com is absolutely great. I highly recommend people to go there. If you guys want some more concrete information, I do have an ebook that I sell called The Everything Guide to Macro Tracking. It'll teach you everything you need to know about what I would give as really concrete nutrition information. So if you want to go there, it's always in my description box. Aside from that, you guys can like ask questions in the comments section. I'll respond back to you as much as I can. Anyways, I will catch you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching. Give the video a thumbs up on your way up.